Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I recorded a video earlier, but the game froze at the loading scene, so I had to press Alt and F4 and start over again. So this is the first time this happened with the game, so we found a pretty serious bug. I played a little bit of multiplayer, and I also decided to craft the Matok assault rifle. You can see it over here. This was my favorite rifle at the previous game, and I used to carry it with the sniper, so I'm gonna try to do the same. So we have options for any kind of scenario. So yeah, let's go back to the game and hope that we don't have any more issues. I'm gonna continue with the main mission. We're gonna go to the next planet that showed that it had that remnant technology with the planet's terraforming abilities. We're back to another long traveling scene. Those are unskippable, guys. I mean, no matter what I press, I cannot skip them. So after time, there's still
we're
not.
We're on a collision course with unknown objects.
Make corrections. Sam, are you on
this? Collision is imminent.
All stop now.
Ships, a dozen. No, more.
They've got us pinned against the Scourge.
They are scanning us, Pathfinder.
Well, scan them back.
Where is the one who activated the remnant? Their DNA signature is there.
Okay, the aliens already speak perfect English.
You're the one in my way. Who are you?
They've lost navigation.
We're being steered into their ship.
Just tell me what you want.
I won't explain what you can't understand.
Ryder, I have almost regained control of the ship. I need a few more seconds.
You can't take a ship full of people just because you feel like it. Who do you think you are?
Enough. Your defiance is naive and reckless. This day marks the beginning of your greatness.
Sam?
I have plotted a potential course through the Scourge.
Do it! Report.
Enemy destroyed. Damage to aft sensors.
Scourge got it?
Yes.
Get us out of here.
It will be tight.
Hello? Yes!
Nice work, kid.
Yeah. But who the hell was that guy?
Ryder, we've got trouble down here. You need to find us a port now.
Great. Where'd we end up anyway?
Sensors are damaged, but I think we're at the vault's coordinates.
You think? Gil, give it what you can. We're setting down.
We're being contacted.
We have to land. Open a comm.
Tov Jagalesto. Tov Jagalesto.
Okay, at least these ones don't speak English yet.
Listen, sorry to just show up like this, but I swear, we're the Galactic good guys.
Efanola, Farhan and Gasadrigara.
Efanola.
They're forcing us to land.
Then we land. Yes. Ha, look at that. It's beautiful. We need in that vault.
Please, you're not really going out there on your own.
We can't afford a repeat of last time. I'm the Pathfinder. First contact is on me.
Most important thing ever. No pressure.
This is what it's all about, right? New worlds, new aliens. Wish me luck. Thank you.
Hey, Hamdel goes.
Mason Roa.
I'm Paran Shai, governor of Arya. We are the Angara.
Hello. I'm a Pathfinder with the Initiative.
Yes. You crossed Darkspace. I've heard of your journey. Jol, I have this in hand.
Ephra saw the ship come in and sent me to find out what's going on.
He's a human from another galaxy. A Pathfinder.
Arya is hidden. Protected. What do you want?
Okay, this guy's already speak English. But maybe the female somehow already knows about, she says she knows about the Initiative, so maybe they had some kind of a contact with somebody from the Initiative before.
We didn't know what we'd find here, to be honest. But I'm open to sharing what we know, if you are.
Honest? Honesty would be a good start. I'll inform Ephra. He'll be waiting for you in his office at the Resistance headquarters. I'll meet you there.
I will accompany you through our city. Your crew will stay on your ship. Follow me. Follow closely. Do not try to explore the city or interact with anyone. Ephra's guards will use force if necessary.
Understood. Is it okay to ask you questions?
I suppose.
Keep moving.
I gotta tell you guys,
if you're the governor, why do I need to see this Ephra?
He's leader of the Resistance.
What's that?
They fight the Ket and protect us.
The level design is amazing, people. I mean, I love it.
We have a visitor.
This isn't safe. We should lock it up.
How about no?
I detect unusual levels of electrostatic energy in the Angara.
I thought I'd see another alien. This isn't safe. It belongs in a containment cell.
We're coming to Shire.
We don't know what you're doing.
Am I that intimidating?
You're an outsider who invaded our home. We know nothing about you.
I'm not here to cause trouble.
Then keep moving.
Okay. Don't shoot me.
How did it find us?
He, not it.
How do you know?
That's a human. I've seen one before.
None of the local flora register in my data file.
Put that away.
What?
It's just a scanner.
Okay.
Put it away now.
Okay.
Take it. Your city is beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, it is.
You're the first outsider to see it.
I'm honored.
Pretty impressive, yeah, guys. The level design is absolutely amazing.
Keep up if you're curious.
What happens if Ephra doesn't like me?
He won't, but you need to earn his trust.
He's responsible for everyone's safety. I know what that's like.
You're a leader.
Trying to be.
This is the Resistance headquarters. Ephra is waiting inside.
Kinda ugly. not much inspiration when making them. They just made them weird.
They are bullies, but this situation is now your fault. Don't get kicked out, Moran, not because of them.
But you're telling me to be weak?
No. I am telling you to be strong, through your cunning and heart. Okay? Hey.
It really is the best one in the Resistance.
I know.
Staring contest, huh?
Our experience with the Ket makes us naturally distrustful of all aliens.
We've had our own run-ins with the Ket.
Then you really do understand. When the Archon came to Helios, he demolished our sovereign state. Took what he wanted, as if we were nothing. Now, the Ket mercilessly abduct Angara. Often, we never see our people again. Come this way. Ephra is waiting.
Wait, the Ket kidnap you? Steal your people?
And the Resistance fights them every day. With everything we can.
Is it attrition? What are they after?
You should save your questions for Ephra.
Katara be damned. I won't lose Vold. Ephra, this is one of the aliens from the Milky Way. A Pathfinder.
Pathfinder. It's an aggressive move coming to Aya.
My people from the Milky Way were bold enough to come to Andromeda. I need to be at least that bold to save them.
So, Pathfinder, never mind how you even found us. Why are you here?
On a hostile planet we call Eos, I explored an ancient structure, a vault, and brought it back online. It stabilized that planet's environment.
Remnant. Recent intelligence supports that claim.
If I'm right, there's a vault on Aya that's different. I need to look inside.
You're right. There's a vault out there, but it was shut years ago and the entrance hidden. We can't help you.
The Moshai could. She's our most revered scientist and elder. She knows this vault.
But now the Ket have her, and our rescue attempts failed. She's lost to us, and you.
Let me show you what I can do. I won't take one step without your approval.
You have no idea what you're dealing with. The Angara learned years ago the perils of messing with vaults. So did the Ket, for that matter. We're done here.
Okay.
Ephra, I feel... Ephra, what this alien says is extraordinary. The Moshai would want us to be brave and not let this chance pass.
Joel, you talk too much.
Let me assess this alien. I'll be your eyes. I know you can spare me.
Go if you want. But when he tries to kill you, be prepared to strike first.
I'm Jarl Amadarav. I'll be your envoy through Angaran space.
Thank you for trusting me.
I don't. But I can always kill you in your sleep.
Good to know.
Okay.
I've organized my analysis of Aya. Shall I relay it to the Nexus?
Definitely.
Yeah, we better talk quiet. So, we just spoke with these guys and they let us roam around their city.
Enjoy the docks. For now, that's all you have access to.
Okay, can go there. Let's see what we have to do over here. Let's go left.
Is alive.
I'm sure of it.
Don't kill yourself bringing her home.
No promises.
Okay, this is our guy.
I'm here to... I am Enro Bosan, assistant to Governor Paranshai. You're free to explore this area, but the city is off limits. Until that changes, I'll be your liaison. How may I help you, Pathfinder?
You don't just stand here waiting to answer my questions, right?
I assist the governor in all matters. While you're here, this is my priority.
Pretty far outside your normal job, huh?
I did not begin this day expecting to speak with it. You?
Nice save.
Yeah, it's been a long day.
Sounded like you and Jahl know each other.
Our families are related.
You sound nothing alike.
We have multiple worlds. Our culture is complex.
I'd like to know more.
Earn our trust and maybe you will.
Okay.
When am I allowed to visit the city again?
That's not for me to decide.
Who will? Your boss? Or Ephra?
Governor Shai has jurisdiction over Aya. She will authorize your entrance if you earn Ephra's trust. A museum curator and a colony supplier asked to meet you. They're waiting nearby. The Ket swayed us with words. Now we judge outsiders by their actions.
What can you tell me about your other worlds?
Life on them is hard. The people harder. Every day is a struggle to survive.
Why not bring everyone here?
We will not abandon any more worlds to the Ket. And Aya cannot support all of us.
Thanks for your time, Enro.
Of course.
Okay, so this guy is didn't answer many questions. Guys, I want to show you again the level design. Check out over there. Birds, some leaves flying down. Check out the clouds. I mean, this is absolutely beautiful scene. And I'm really impressed.
Stars above! It's you! I was hoping to get a chance to speak with you. You left your home to cross dark space. Is it true you can never go back?
Yeah. This is home now.
To take such a risk and give up your old life. Why did you do it?
Shit. I don't want to romance this thing, but let's do it because it's the more fun option.
For the chance to meet someone like you. Looks like it already paid off.
Are all humans as quick with words?
You'll have to find out.
I suppose I will.
My turn for a question. Do I get to know your name?
Oh, of course. I'm Avela Kajawa, curator for the Repository of History. We study relics of our past, try to piece together what we lost in the Scourge. And, the truth is, there was something I wanted to talk to you about. Pathfinder, how much do you know about our history?
I still have a lot to learn.
Centuries ago, the Scourge targeted my people. Our ships were the first to go dark. Many of those ships went down over Havaral. The wilds of that planet are filled with history. A scientist on Havaral just contacted me with a new nav point of an intact crash site. A huge opportunity. But with Remnant patrolling the area, we can't get close enough. Not like you can.
How do you know about me and the Remnant?
I have friends in the Resistance. They heard your conversation with Ephra. I know it's a lot to ask, but you have a ship, and the means to get past the Remnant. Without your help, I'm stuck.
You're trusting your history with an outsider?
I know what people say about you, but I don't agree. I think you're here to help.
I am.
Now's your chance to prove it. You want to earn Aya's respect, right? Recovering our past will go a long way.
I don't think Ephra would be too happy with this arrangement.
Ephra doesn't have to know. And if he finds out, he can direct his anger at me.
It takes guts to stand up to him.
I'd face worse to get a piece of our history back.
I've always wanted to give archaeology a try.
Oh, I was hoping you'd say that. If you find anything, I'll be here. Thank you, Pathfinder.
Okay, these aliens don't know us much, but they're already giving us quests, so there is something missing. I hope there's some history to be revealed to explain that trust we just witnessed, but yeah, I'm not a big fan of the legs, so I don't think I'm gonna romance you. I'm gonna flirt a little bit though.
You send the human.
I cannot scan them. Let's check around. I mean, it's a beautiful, beautiful map, so. At least location, so.
What's that about hearing? I mean,
Okay, guys, at times I felt like I'm interrupting conversations that I'm not supposed to, like talking to this guy, he had some lines to say, so whatever. What is this thing? Yeah, so a lot of times the game doesn't kind of feel intuitive. When am I supposed to talk to somebody and when am I can interrupt them?
Trade? Trade. Trade.
Are you asking or telling?
Wondering, do you exchange goods and services? How does your economy work?
I thought he just learned a little bit English, but I mean, he's okay for an alien. He has much better English than I do, especially grammatically. I'm very impressed.
We pay for things with a currency called credits, abstract wealth.
The cat offered gifts, made odd bargains, never traded. What are your credits worth? What can we do with them?
You pay them to us for whatever we're selling.
Now we cut open the heart. What do you offer?
I don't know. What do you want?
Your ship? Not for sale. Worth a try.
Is there something else I can do for you?
Yes. Call me Soka. I run cargo between Aya and other worlds. Good work. Good at it. You're here to help my people. Prove it. I need help. One of my suppliers off-world stopped checking in. Has things I need. There could be trouble.
What makes you think I can help?
You found Aya, maybe you find my supplier. Can't hurt to ask.
You're one of few people here willing to give me a chance. I'll take it.
You have a ship? I have my supplier's nav point. His name is Kelvo. Find him, his supplies. Come back and prove you're helpful. Then maybe we trade.
It's still, somebody needs to explain why those aliens speak English, like most of them. Without translator, without anything. They don't have an implanted AI in their brain, so the game should tell you how exactly they did that. I'm baffled. Look, you're all aliens to me. Okay. Anything over here? Fragile. The kid have felt the power of the resistance and they know their end is coming. Our victories on Vold are only the beginning of what we can achieve, but we can't defeat the enemy without your help. If you're tired of living in fear, if you believe we're meant for something greater than slavery, if you're willing to stand up and fight, you'll find a new family in the resistance. We'll train you to strike back at the kid and reclaim what is ours. The resistance defends the future of Oangara. Join us. Kinda reminds me of Star Wars now. I mean, this game reminds me about a lot of stuff. I mean, Dragon Age Inquisition, obviously, for the crafting system or whatever. And too many quests you can take. I mean, check this out. How am I supposed to... additional tasks. Look at this shit. Helios assignments. This is one palette. This is the first one. Okay, we have another four. Relationships. Priority ops. I mean, it really feels I'm just like piling quests and I don't know how am I supposed to complete them. So this is from Dragon Age Inquisition. That's really not a good thing to catch. Maybe somebody likes a lot of content, a lot of missions, but I kind of... Oh my god, this is beautiful. Look at this. It's absolutely beautiful. But still, too many missions.
Rider, ship's fixed up and ready to fly.
No explanation how they did it. No backstory.
Your ship is... We have nothing like it.
Where do you see the inside?
It gets better.
Oh yeah.
You ready to go?
I'll introduce you to the rest of my crew.
Okay. We got a new crew member. They kind of forced themselves into the crew. This guy. we're not gonna check them. I mean, we just made a contact with a new race. We don't check if they're contagious to us, what kind of food they eat, what kind of, bed they require, or if they take a shower, or if they drink a sofa or whatever. It would just take
a
minute.
I'm just saying, as far as first contact goes, at least that went better than the last one.
Only slightly.
Yeah, what happened? I wanted to look around.
And now we have another mouth to feed, whatever he eats.
My question exactly.
Do the translators not work?
They work.
Oh, they're some kind of a translators. Okay, that explains everything.
I know we're improvising as we go, but let's remember that there is Pathfinder Team Protocol.
Don't think I got that handbook. Ryder, we followed our best lead here, and now we don't even have that.
Jahl has offered to do what he can to help us access the Vault on Aya.
How do we do that when we're leaving the planet it's on?
That's a fair point. Jahl?
Seriously?
Settle down. Ryder's right. There's an Angara right here. Let's hear from the new guy.
One day, about 80 years ago, the Archon and the Ket arrived in Helios, and the horror began.
They declared war?
Nothing so easy to define or fight.
The Ket kidnap Angara. Their people disappear without a trace. What if they were us?
Sure, I'll fight Ket all day long, but that's no plan.
I agree. We need to get into that vault, Ryder. Surprisingly, I'm with PB. Our own mission has to take priority.
We have a plan. Kind of. Pretty solid. Jahl?
The resistance is stretched thin. I was tasked with traveling to two of our worlds at our briefing this morning. And you'll accompany me.
Because?
Because then Ephra will see you as trustworthy. You want that.
Jahl's told me about these two worlds, Havarl and Vold.
Before the Scourge disaster, Vold was a thriving planet of billions, a shining center of technology and life.
And now?
It's the center of our ground war against the Ket. Our resistance base is fighting Ket Command for control of the planet.
What about the other?
Havarl? Is the birthplace of the Angara. It's started to degrade, to become wild and dangerous. We suspect Remnant.
Now we're talking.
We've recently lost contact with our scientists.
Still don't get how any of this helps us.
I do. Help us, or rather help me, and I'll vouch for you, right? Because Jahl wants inside Aya's vault, too.
Pathfinder, it's your call.
Don't know yet. Just be ready to go at a moment's notice. Got it?
You bet.
Jahl, give Kalo the nav points for both planets. Let's do this.
Let's do this. I mean, this guy is a pathfinder that 20,000 people are relying on. He's in charge of the sexiest starship ever. I mean, look at this. It's like a penthouse, okay? And he's acting like a, 18-year-old teenager in a teen comedy or whatever. I mean, come on, dude. Be more manly. I mean, I hope we see this character progress a little bit in the game. Man up a little bit. Get some steel.
Still compiling my first impressions, but even their body language is so emotional. I can't wait for my first session with Jahl.
Try not to scare him away, huh?
What is this? Oh, okay. Those bonuses I get. Zero crap whatsoever. Okay. Okay, Doctor, what do you think about the new guy?
Ryder?
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Okay. Obviously nothing much to check. Let me see where this guy is. Yeah, BB. Let's see. Liam. Okay. And where am I? Okay, I'm here. Okay, let's check Joe and go and check PV after that. I think she had some kind of a mission for me or some update. What do you do here?
One hell of a trip this is turning out to be. Hostiles, ruined worlds, no home in sight. Everyone's getting toasty. There was a 2-hour argument yesterday and no one even knew how it started.
That's not good.
Luckily, I have the perfect way for people to unwind. Movie night.
Taking okay. a breather for a good movie? I could get behind that.
Best part is, it doesn't need to be good. Still get mileage out of the bad ones. It's worth it to jumpstart everyone's pioneer spirit and all that. The Tempest database is pretty dry. Could you download a movie library from Nexus Ops to see what I've got to work with?
If I have time.
Thanks. Everyone will appreciate it.
Okay, the Pathfinder right now is in charge to the to getting some movies for everybody. Okay. Nothing so, better to do, right?
Jarl.
So?
We haven't had a chance to talk alone. You comfortable in here?
I took it. It feels strange to stay with the others. They are... you are... aliens.
Oh, fuck you, you're the aliens.
And you're alien to us. So there, we have something in common.
We can look at it as a place to start.
Got it.
Perhaps then, if we're all aliens, it's about what kind of alien we are.
You had no idea about us, but you signed up to help us anyway.
Perhaps it had nothing to do with you.
Care to elaborate?
I do not.
Enough said.
How do you know Moshe Sefa?
She's our greatest mind on the Remnant. I was his student.
You studied the Remnant too?
A little. I was terrible. I quit. Or she threw me out. One of those. We're still very close.
So, is that your rifle?
It is now. It's Ket. With my own modifications. I like to tinker, to get my hands on something and take it apart.
That's a skill I know we can use. But I have one request. Please don't take apart my ship.
You're right. I signed up. Volunteered for this. It's exciting. There's something unique about you. Uneasy, raw, but somehow profound.
Face value, that sounds like a compliment. A nice one.
It is. Angara feel deeply. We have more trouble hiding our emotions than showing them. I should get back to my work.
As if I didn't have enough on my plate, add deciphering alien psychology.
What plate?
Exactly. See you later.
Oh, finally, a reference he didn't get. Now he's gonna... Wow. This place now looks up and running. Okay, don't run, bitch. I want to know more about you aliens.
Yes?
What's your story, Jarl? Tell me about yourself.
Why?
Well, why wouldn't you? You hiding something?
Maybe. That would only make sense.
You're messing with me, right?
Possibly. What does it mean?
It's an idiom. It means you're joking, trying to make me feel uncomfortable.
Ah, then no. Ephra instructed me to be cautious. I'm not very good at being cautious. That's enough. Until we've established a better trust with each other.
Okay, a man of many words. Okay, let's go check Quora. Because we wanna get in her pants. And actually, she's the one. Oh, BB. Okay. Again, she was starting to say something. I couldn't listen to it.
Maybe the Angara will let me pitch a tent on Aya for the duration.
How about they start talking a little bit further when I'm a little bit further away from them? I mean, that kind of sucks. They kind of start saying something that might be funny, might be interesting, might give us a little bit more atmosphere. And when I start pressing the button, it's not all the way down. They start saying something. That kind of sucks.
You'd let a bone-faced blowhard like that deprive you of my scintillating company?
That blowhard hates you now. If you're not careful, he might deprive me of your company. All right. Next time, keep him on the line. I might have something to say.
I like it when you flirt. I wouldn't want you to stop.
Have I flirted with you? Don't worry, Ryder. I'm relentless. It relaxes me.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
All right, we'll talk later. This guy, Gil... he's just boring. I really don't want to talk to him right now. And that's something new. That's something I've never done in Mass Effect. I've been such a huge fan of the series. I own the DLC. I spent most of my points on the BioWare store, where you can get, you know, extra weapons, extra lore, and stuff like that. And what the fuck is this? Jesus, that's ugly. Okay. So, yeah, this is the first time in a Mass Effect game that I don't want to talk to every single character and learn more about the story and the relationships and the little quests you can get. It's a bit disappointing, really. The camera plays tricks on me over here. Let's see if we can talk to somebody else. Is this a medbay? Yeah. Looks like it.
You're taking the Angara, old man?
Strong, honorable survivors. Been a while since I encountered a new friendly species. Last time was the humans.
Oh yeah, you lived through first contact with them, didn't you?
If I recall, my exact words were, they're bold for being so squishy. Do they know they're mostly water?
Harsh. Don't let Ryder hear you.
I heard you. And by the way, that's pretty good. I mean, that's from Garden Zombies or whatever. that's pretty funny. After action report, fire drill. Sam's new vacation plan costs 22 seconds. Rack, we need a solution for vis-a-vis letters. I don't know what that means, guys. I hope you do. PB, you're dead because you were 2 minutes late for the evac point, okay? I live in an escape pod. That's okay, that's a pretty good one. Whoever wrote it, good job, finally.
Hey, Ryder.
Nothing to say.
You probably have work to do.
You know where to find me.
Okay, I do. No, actually, I don't, because you guys change places all the time. Which is actually good. A little bit more diverse. Okay, nothing to say here, too. Yeah, whatever. Okay, let's get to the... actually, this is my place. Is there anything new in my emails? Let me check my email. From Tech. BB. Okay, I'm gonna read those later. Another interview ready. What is this? Dr. Adriana. Okay, yeah. PB. Oh no, spirituality. I wanna read this, I wanna check how boring this character my turn. I'm so glad for our chat earlier. I've had to defend what I believe so often that, and I have to admit, I'm a little bit tired of it. Whenever I meet someone who feels the same or just understands, I really appreciate it. So thank you. That was the most boring email ever. From Zhao, our new crew member. Let me check this. It's probably gonna be funny, but I don't have time to read it because it's kinda long. Have some news from this place. Whatever. Gonna check it after I'm done with the video. What is this place? Is this a treadmill? What is this? Oh, okay. That's something new. This, obviously we're gonna have five planets we can upgrade. make them more tolerable for colonization. Didn't check that. I didn't see that before. It's there if you need it. Nothing much to check right now.
Aya has so much biodiversity and the waterfalls.
Just like Sirkesh.
Yeah, it kind of reminds you of Sirkesh. I think we saw it in Mass Effect 2 for the... No, actually, we saw it in Mass Effect 3 by rescuing the female Krogan.
We might have a problem. I was running some numbers, mass balances and such. The Tempest is carrying about 70 kilos of extra mass. I think something's aboard that doesn't belong.
70 kilos is enough mass for another person.
Our internal sensors aren't getting anything, but they're not as powerful as a Pathfinder's scanner. Can you take a look?
All right. I'll look around the ship and see what I can find.
I think we had probably a 70 kilogram cat snuck in. I gotta scan the ship a little bit later. I'm not gonna do it right now.
Sam's been compiling our star charts. The other pilots on the Nexus will have plenty of new trails to follow.
You can drop the charts off the next time we're there.
Funny. A few months ago, that station was like a war zone. Flying was my only way to escape the chaos. Now it's become a haven, just as it was meant to be.
It could use a lake? What the fuck does that mean?
Everyone's really working to get the Nexus on its feet.
Regardless, the worst threat to the whole initiative is still that monstrosity.
You mean the Scourge?
I still see it crippling the Nexus in my memories. I had to train other pilots in hazardous flight techniques just to look for food and water. It's a cage that eats good ships and good people. Helios won't be home so long as it's a threat.
It's a huge space anomaly. It's not going away in anyone's lifetime.
If we could somehow neutralize it, or if our ships had defenses against it. Still, that's what we do, isn't it? Find a way where there is none. Just see the Nexus for proof of that.
Okay, this conversation is the first interesting thing that this guy has said. It kind of make it a little bit creepy, spooky and scary, you know? But the Scourge, I can finally start appreciating that it's, you know, dangerous.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, let's check those anomalies.
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
I hope it helps me craft the sniper rifle finally. Guys, I just wanna reach a point of this game where I can finally use a proper sniper rifle, you know? That just pops somebody's head at the first shot, you know? Two at most. Now this one feels like a BB gun. Okay, we got, I think, substantial amount of beryllium. Hope I could use it for something useful. Okay. Am I supposed to go up to any of those plants? I mean, they have something kind of a shield. And this is the Scourge, obviously. It's all over the place. Like, huge clouds of solidified gas. You know, I don't know how else to explain it in a term that someone can understand. Including me. Yeping the scientist. Which one is a main quest? Yeah, I think this one. So yeah, let's go here. Okay, this is the
sensors.
Yeah, I'm gonna check the anomaly later, okay? I don't need a little bit more minerals I'm not gonna use anytime soon. So we're going to the home system of the new aliens, the Agara, I think they were. So we're gonna see their Earth, their starting home planet. I hope it's gonna be... It's not a planet, it's a moon. Huge jungle planet. but it's orbiting a bigger gas giant or something. Now imagine that. Imagine we actually... our home planet was actually the moon. And every day in the sky we would see the Earth. How awesome would that be? I mean, not that awesome, but still, think about it. It's kind of a fun thing too, you know? Okay, how am I supposed to... How can I land? I'm scanning. Oh, okay, I gotta go up here. Oh, check out those storms. And a hurricane that's actually moving. Guys, do you think it's moving? Or is it just me? Little slightly, you know. Yeah, it's twisting a little bit, I can see it. That's pretty nice touch. Okay, we're gonna use the medic I told you about. It's my favorite assault rifle from at least Mass Effect 2. So yeah, I'm gonna start using it first. Oh, thank you. What kind of options do I have? Oh, we have some yeah, I could use those just in case. Nomad customization. Midas touch. Ultra Ren Nomad paint job. Maintenance high panache. Okay. What is this? Nomad paint job. Ooh, I got it. I don't like it that much, but I'm just gonna try it. I don't like it more than that. Point for Dapalev.
That's where the Emotions team should be. It used to be an Angaran town. There'll be landing pads and good sightlines for a safe approach.
Anomaly on the sensors. Something big, possibly hostile, taking evasive action.
Wait! I don't think it's...
Oh shit.
Well, that's something you don't see back home.
Bringing us in.
Okay, we're on a new planet. Yeah, look at that. A flying fish thing. Nothing to scan around. Why do I have Liam? Can I make a choice who am I bringing with me? Okay, well guys, this is where I'm gonna cut the video. I think it's quite long enough. And I'll see you next time. We're gonna explore this place. See you next time.